I mean, incredible. I couldn't sleep the first night after seeing them. Just it was just you're so excited, your blood's boiling, you're so enthusiastic, and you just want to keep seeing them more and more and more. So just an incredible experience.
But most of the sharks are really calm and just swim by and look at you and just are calm and adorable.
Well, what I thought I liked about them and what I've seen is definitely different. So, surprise, yes, they're far calmer than I thought they would be. Almost cute. I know it sounds really weird because when I came here, I wasn't expecting to see that. I kind of expected to see this predator who was going to just be jumping up and attacking everything. And actually, the reality is so different that and they've all got different personalities. And I think that's the thing that's really surprised me. And I've just become so fond of them.
My first great white was 2.5 meters. And I've watched a lot of documentaries and stuff to learn most about them. And when I actually saw a white shark, it was quite small, actually. But then a few weeks later, I saw a 3.5 meter female white shark. And then, those are a lot bigger. And then you see a proper white shark. The marine biologists here, Tom and Georgie, they know a lot about white sharks. But not only white sharks, also everything marine related.
I always wanted to get closer. I wanted to do the opposite to everyone else. Everyone wanted to get away. I wanted to get closer, learn more. And even from watching sharks at an early age, I could see that they were very calm. We get population estimates by dorsal fin. So dorsal fin, the back edge, the trailing edge, which we call a posterior margin, has notches, little indentations, and each has an individual fin. So what we're trying to do at the moment and is ongoing is getting as many fins at the right angle and comparing them and constantly going through.
Well, the male sharks have two claspers. They're like two white sausages on the between the pelvic fins, and the females don't have them. But when they are smaller, it's quite difficult because the claspers of the male shark are really tiny when the sharks are small. So then you need to look from the cage itself. So that's why it's important for volunteers to dive too in the cage so they can actually take a look from underneath.
White shark populations, often people ask why it is going down. One of the main things we need to think about firstly before even thinking of threats is looking at this animal's life history. Obviously, as an apex predator, you have a slower life history, so a later sexual maturity, low fecundity, so a low number of pups, and generally quite long gestation periods or pregnancy periods. We're now looking at potentially for a female to reach an age of sexual maturity where she can mate for the very first time. We're looking at about 35 years old. So our population is moving sometimes. One of our sharks, Nicole, left Hans Bay and was in Australia 99 days later, off a place called Exmouth off Western Australia, and then back again in less than 9 months. So they're moving out of areas where they are protected and are looked after.
It's really good to contribute to changing people's perspective from fear to respect. And that's the part I like to do and try to do the most.
I've genuinely loved it. There's just such a mix of age ranges here. Everybody's got the common interest in sharks being here, but just a great bunch of people.
It's like one big family. You do games, you watch movies, you cook together, you share a house together. It's amazing. It's really fun.
Having respect for the ocean once they leave here is the most important thing.
See sharks and learn about sharks, definitely did that. The bonus was just being with a great bunch of people when I was here.
So take some hoodies with you. It can be nice and warm, but South Africa is a bit colder than I expected it to be. So bring some warm stuff.
And you'll just have an amazing time. I'd say a whale of a time, but you'll have a shark at the time.